Afternoon, guys. Kenny here, Brave the Wilds. Today, we're going to be discussing a new water tank system for the cabin. Stay tuned.
Okay. This is our water tank system. Yes, straight up, it is a wagon. I haven't used it in years, and I had this idea and I needed a wagon, so I figured I'd use this thing. I'm not really sure how long it's going to last because it's definitely not really meant for this much weight, but we're going to see what happens. So, this is filling up right now. What this is just an 18-gallon plastic container, and it's a rugged tote, and I'll show you guys that on the side here in a second. It's pretty heavy-duty. I felt the bottom. It doesn't have a lot of give to it. I don't think I'm going to have a problem with it breaking, but it could happen, and if it does, I'll probably upgrade to a even more rugged, probably 27-gallon tank that I saw. I bought this at Lowe's for $8, so that tells you right there, it's a pretty cheap investment. This whole system probably cost me 12 bucks. So let me go ahead and give you a close-up of this, and we'll show you how I've got it set up. So it is basically a water tower. So what this is right here, and as you can see, we have a small drip leak because I'll explain to you kind of my mistake in this system here in a second, how you guys can fix it. But all it is there's an adapter or a coupling. I can't remember which one it is. It's basically the male end. It's a slip and thread on the other side that goes through the water tank, and I'll show you guys that in a second. This is all PVC pipe, 3/4 PVC pipe. So I'm thinking this is the adapter. We have a threaded adapter over here, a piece of pipe, and then our union, and this is 1/2 of the union right here. I can go ahead and take this camera off, and I can show you on the inside. What I have is I have the other side, which is basically a female coupling or an adapter. Can't remember quite which one it is. But the thing is, my union meets up in the cabin, and I'll bring you guys down there and show you that later. But it meets up to the union, which is what kind of stops the water flow. But as you can see, it's see-through. There's no blocking it all the way. I don't have any type of shutoff valve in this particular setup, and that was kind of my mistake. So basically what I had to do was make a homemade plug. As you can see, it's just a piece of bike inner tube wrapped around the stick. And as you can see, that makes a really good seal because there's really not any water dripping out. So all I do is there's a little bit right there, but once I meet this up with the cabin and screw it on, I have zero leaks, then I can just take my plug out and I'm good to go. So basically you can see what that is. It's up on blocks to get the right height that I need, and my hose is about to fill this thing up all the way. So that's pretty much it, all I need to show you guys up here. So let's go ahead and take it down to the cabin and I'll show you how the main setup works. Go ahead and do it on the other side for you. Okay, so this is the part you guys are going, what is he doing? But believe it or not, this is our new water tank system. We're no longer hauling 5-gallon buckets up to the countertop so we can use that as a sink. No, we've got almost 20 gallons of water, and you know we need to be able to get it up onto the elevation that we need, and we're not going to be able to do that with one person very easily. Also, it's a lot of space to take up on a countertop. So I decided I'm going with a sleeker system and a more efficient system. And what I did was I actually built a ramp and a sitting platform for this new system. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to bring this up with a pulley system to sit up on top of here. Because, you know, this is 18 gallons and water weighs 8 pounds a gallon. You know, you tell me, that's quite a bit of weight. Especially since I'm considering upgrading to maybe even a 27-gallon tank, which is very big. But 18 gallons should be enough for me. So, let me go ahead and get this pulley system set up and you guys will see exactly what I'm talking about. Unfortunately, guys, I did leave my carabiner up at the house, but that's okay. We'll make do.
Good enough.
This will be our fixed point for our 2-to-1 pulley system. Alright, hopefully you guys now are understanding what I'm saying. Basically, this is just a water transportation system. You can use a four-wheeler, you can use whatever you've got. But this is just what I have, and since I'm not going very far to come down here, this is the most convenient for me. So all you saw was I had a three-quarter union over there that I just quick connected, and that other section is our spigot, which runs through the wall. I drilled a one-inch hole through the wall, and then we can get to our sink system and the shutoff valve. So, all we do now, once we get it down here, is we just take that strap off, pop the lid off, and we have to take that plug out, right? Well, I don't like putting my hands in clean water that we're going to use, so I just take a stick that's fairly clean. I haven't used it for anything. And I just kind of push that cap left and right, and then once it comes out, it floats right to the top where I can just pick it up. Now, that water has flown through this pipe. If you guys can see that,
yep,
it's flowing through the pipe, and then we have a shutoff valve on the other side, which keeps that water from going. And this is how we supply our water to our cabin. So we're inside the cabin now, and as you can see, this is the same sink from when I did the chapter of the hut on the new kitchen area. It's the same sink, but now I've just extended the pipe out, same shutoff valve, and I just have a block of wood here with two nails that gives it left and right stability. So now we can just turn the water on like so and turn it off one-handed. It's very, very stable right there, and it gives us all our stability. So we turn it on, and it gives us quite a bit of water. Obviously, we don't need to blast it like that. But for any dishes or whatnot that we need to clean, hands we need to wash, things like that, we now have plenty of water for the night and the morning. And probably we could stretch it out to 2 days if we were pretty conservative with our water. So let me go ahead and take you guys outside and explain to you basically the rest of the system. So in the back here, next to the fireplace, is basically our main system for this water tank starts. This is the tracks that it rides up, and as you can see, it's just got two side pieces and the main tracks. That way it'll keep it from falling off left or right. And then we use our pulley system to get it up. It's a 2-to-1 pulley system where we have a fixed point. The pulley is connected to the thing that we're hauling, and then we pull on the other side so that we only have to pull 50% of the weight to get it up here, because this is a pretty steep angle. This is a 6-foot or maybe a 7-foot ramp, but with that amount of water and stuff, it's still at a pretty good angle. So this allows us to only have to pull half that weight up. As you guys can see over here, barely in the frame, we have two stop blocks just in case, so that wheelbarrow doesn't fall back when we're trying to bring it back up. We've kind of got our track here. It's a bit muddy because it rained yesterday, but this is where it starts, and we bring it up. And then right here, as you can see, we have our spigot, which is draining water right now. I have the sink on, and when it's full blast, it comes out of this pipe as much as possible. Like, I mean, it's got full 1-inch, that's a 1-inch pipe, so 1-inch tube of water is just flying out through here when we really have it running. And so I have a little canal that you can see right here that runs straight into the creek, so we don't have to worry about washing this out. This is a bit muddy right here, so I might fill this with gravel, so that way we don't have so we don't make tracks in the mud here when we're doing it, because it did rain yesterday, so it might slow us down a little bit. But like I said, with our 2-to-1 pulley system, it's extremely easy to get this water up the. So there you have it, guys. That is my new system for water down here. This, like I said, is 18 gallons. I can upgrade to whatever size I need for depending on how much water I use. I hope you guys kind of understand how the system works with the 2-to-1 pulley system. That 2x6 in the background is where I tie on that fixed point. It's a bit of a jerry rig. I'll probably come up with a more professional rig that works a bit better in the future, but right now that works pretty much as good as I need it. So I have that fixed point back there, run it through the pulley, which is connected to this thing, and then I pull the other end, and that makes it half the weight that we have to bring up the ramp. Besides that, we have our union. So we have a quick connect system. So we just got our main component of the sink right there, the pipe that actually fits into the tank, and then we got that quick connect. If you guys were to build something like this, I recommend you put a shutoff valve on this tank itself that you can shut it off and keep it from leaking as you fill it up. So that way you don't have to cork it like I have to, since I forgot. I had a total brain cramp when I made it. I should have put a shutoff valve on there, but it's like $5 or $6. So I kind of would have probably went the cheapo route anyway and just stuck with a cork. It doesn't really leak that much. And if it just leaks a drop or two, you know, coming down here, that's not a big deal to me, especially since you lose a little bit of water off the top when you're bringing up the ramp anyway, because this is not a sealed container. It's got gaps between the lid and the tank, so it makes it leak. But if you have 16 gallons of water in here, that's way more than enough for the night, and it works great for us. I know you guys are probably going to ask, well, what do you do when it drops down below freezing and your water freezes up? I've kind of come up with two possibilities. I haven't yet had it drop below freezing camping out down here with this water tank system, but I think I know how I'm going to do it to keep the pipes from freezing up and things like that. Either I'm going to drain it the night before, and then I'll bring in another gallon bucket or 5-gallon bucket of water and fill this thing up in the morning, or I'll just take the water that's in here and flush it out into a 5-gallon bucket. That way the pipes won't freeze up overnight outside. I can leave that bucket, you know, proximal to the stove, so that way the water won't freeze when it's in there. And then I can just come out here in the morning and fill it right back up, and we're good with our water. Especially since in the mornings we don't do very elaborate meals, so we don't need that much water when we're doing dishes. So 5 gallons of water, or maybe I have a 7-gallon bucket. If I just fill that thing up with the remainder of the water in here, it'll be good enough for the morning. And that way this will be dry overnight and won't freeze our pipes or freeze the water inside. So that's pretty much it, guys. To get a full understanding of how this cabin works and how the kitchen system works, you can feel free to check out some of my other videos on the Chapter the Hut series. If you guys aren't informed on that, I explain everything to do with this cabin. I've burned it out. I've talked about every single thing in there, how it works and things like that. This is just an addition to the system, or modification to the system, to make it so I have a lot more water down here. You can easily do some kind of a system to heat this water outside if you wanted to with some stove pipes, but that's a bit more expensive and a bit more elaborate than I need to go with this simple setup. So I thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you have a great week. Have a safe and Merry Christmas, and I'll see you on the next video.